I worked very hard with my team.
Doctors Marion CROAK and Patricia Bath will soon be inducted into the National Inventors Hall of Fame. Against huge odds and through science, they've persevered and changed our lives. Dr. CROAK is a vice president of engineering at Google and holds some 200 patents. She's credited with bringing us voice over the internet while working at Bell Labs.
There was a decision made to combine the data and voice networks, and many different alternatives were looked at for that, and I was a very strong proponent of trying voice over IP to have an internet network, a network that connected people through the internet and then put voice traffic on it. And many of the colleagues that I worked with at the time doubted that we could ever make it work.
But CROAK, who grew up on Manhattan's Upper West Side and graduated from Princeton and USC, would not be deterred. She and her small team worked tirelessly to put voices over the internet in a reliable way.
It took quite a lot of time and effort and failure to do it, but we eventually got it done. And I guess the rest is history. So you and I are talking over voice over IP right now.
That technology is the basis for much of our communication, especially during the pandemic.
Many times when you're making a wireless call, definitely when you're making a call from your home phone, you're using voice over IP. And in all the communications that are going on now through Zoom and Meet and other technologies, and other services are using voice over IP.
The technology has also been adapted in other ways. American Idol used it to allow viewers to cast their votes in the talent contest.
The first person to make it through tonight is...
That led Dr. CROAK to another idea, instantly raising money for those in need.
I mean, we could do it for something like American Idol. Why couldn't we do it for people who are suffering from some sudden tragedy?
CROAK says it's an honor to be inducted into the Hall of Fame.
I'm happy that there was recognition for the work that had been done. It was hard work at the time, but I'm glad that people have been able to use the technology so much, especially during this pandemic.
Dr. CROAK will go into the Hall of Fame with another New Yorker. Dr. Patricia Bath created and holds the patent on a type of cataract surgery that she invented back in 1986. It's called laser phaco.
Laser phaco is a new technique in which laser energy, rather than ultrasound energy, is used to fragment the lens nucleus.
Dr. Bath is a CUNY alum, having graduated from Hunter College before going on to Howard University Medical School and Columbia before landing at UCLA. She died in 2019, but she was the first African-American female doctor to receive a medical patent. Her daughter, Dr. Erica Bath.
My mother determined the way to use lasers. Lasers really hadn't been applied successfully for cataracts. And so she figured out the frequency, the temperature, the amount of time to really bring that type of technology to cataracts.
Dr. Erica Bath is an associate professor at the David Geffen UCLA School of Medicine, where she holds a number of leadership positions. She says her mother's invention used a smaller probe that allowed for quicker recovery times because the incision was smaller. Patricia Bath also co-founded the American Institute for Blindness, and while interning at Harlem Hospital, she discovered that African Americans were twice as likely to suffer blindness and eight times as likely to develop glaucoma as their white counterparts.
What my mom noted was that at Harlem Hospital, at the eye clinic, there were no surgeries being done, which was different at Columbia, where they were doing ophthalmic procedures.
A woman who accomplished many firsts, she got surgeons from Columbia to come to Harlem Hospital and perform the first eye surgeries there and developed a community ophthalmology system, providing eye care for those who couldn't afford it.
I would love for her to be remembered as a, you know, visionary, innovator, pioneer, trailblazer, humanitarian.
In the meantime, Dr. Marian CROAK has a message for all thinking of going into science-related fields.
So I would encourage young women, people of color, to please join me in pursuing STEM and just working in technology companies. We need you. We definitely need you.
I'm Mike Gilliam for Simply Science.